I am Christelle from Diabetes Strong, and in this video, I'll be showing you how to set up your Freestyle Libre 2 CGM. So that includes how to set up your receiver, how to apply the sensor, as well as how to set up your alarms. First thing first, you need to set up your reader. So I already took it out of the box yesterday and charged it. It does come with a charger, so it's fully charged. Here we go. So this is the reader. See the size of my hand here, but let's take off the plastic film here. So first things first is I want to simply start it up. You do that by clicking the bottom down here and you can see it's starting up. Then it says which language, English or Spanish for me. So I say English, you just click the screen and you click there's an okay up here in the corner. Okay, next here, what is the date? So today is, actually got it right, it's July 29th. I just click next. It says, what time is it? It got the time right as well, which is pretty, well, almost. It's 11 here, 11 p.m. in California, 21. So you just simply use the touch screen. I can't really show you that, but you can see I'm just touching it, now the time is there, and then it says next down here. So you click that. And then it gives you an explanation of what does the arrows mean. So simply, you can read that, how quickly things are starting. It's explaining if you see this symbol, it's like a blood drop and a magnifying glass. It means that you need to verify all readings with a blood sugar measurement. So use a finger pricker, do the next. It's telling you that it's also a meter. If you want to use that, I don't have testers for it, however, so I can't do that. Click next, showing you where you could apply your sensor. So it's basically just taking you through the basics. And that's done. Alrighty, now we're ready. So let's get the sensor ready. Okay, let's get the sensor ready. This is the sensor, it comes in the pack, so you simply take it out. Go, there are instructions and all that good stuff with it. It also comes with, well, alcohol swabs. I already have those, but it's all good. So these are the components, okay? So first thing you wanna do is you wanna peel the lid off the sensor pack. So this is the sensor pack. Oh, it even says sensor pack here. So you want to peel the lid off. Simply pull it. Wow, you need a little bit of finger strength here. Peel that completely off, put that aside. Then you want to unscrew the cap from the sensor applicator. So this is the sensor applicator. This is a cap. So we're going to unscrew that. There we go. We'll put that aside as well. You can actually see the sensor in here. Okay, so you want to line up the marks on the sensor and applicator, and you want to have it on the hard surface. So say that's a mark, and there's a mark here. Okay, so we're gonna align those. You see that one is aligned with that one, and then you're gonna press down. Alrighty, so then you simply lift the applicator out of the sensor pack. Here we go. You can actually see the needle now. See, it's in there. So we're ready to apply it to the arm. Let's go do that. So the Libre is assembled and we're ready to go, but first you want to clean the skin. So they actually provided this alcohol prep swabs. I do have some, but let's just use theirs, why not? And it's meant to go on the back of your arm. So this is where it's gonna go. So I'm just gonna dry down the skin. This makes sure, you know, helps so that the sensor will stay on for longer. So I highly recommend doing this. Okay, just gonna let that dry for a second. Don't touch it, just let it dry. I just let my arm dry for a second and I'm ready to apply the sensor. So you hold on to the gray part and simply press it against the skin. Haven't tried the Libre 2 before, so this is new to me as well. So let's do this together. So we cleaned the back of the arm, supposed to put it up against the skin and then simply push down. There you go. Well, that was super easy. And then you throw this away. Let's put that aside. Just want to make sure that's actually sticking to the skin. Sticking. Cool. So next up is that we want to start it in the reader. I got on the reader. First step is you simply press the big button. So that one. Turns on, and you can see here it's actually prompting you. It says you want to start a new sensor. So you click that. Start a new sensor. And then it's saying, okay, hold it up towards the sensor. I'm just going to do that. Scan sensor to start it. Woohoo! There we go. It's just giving me a warning telling me, you know, high doses of vitamin C can mess with the sensor, stuff like that. So there's a little okay up here in the corner. Click that. New sensor starting up. Sensor can be used in 60 minutes. So that's because the startup period for the Libre 2 is 60 minutes. So in 60 minutes, I should start getting readings. Let's have a look at the alarms. So this is a touchscreen. You open up the front screen up here in the right-hand corner. This is a little simple. And here you click alarms. So here you can see the factory settings. So low glucose is 70 milligrams per deciliter, high glucose is 240, signal loss is on. So you can change those by simply clicking here on change alarm settings. Let's do that. Say we want to change the low glucose. Say I already want to be warned when I'm at. So you can say done. But let's say instead I don't want the low glucose alert at all. I can just click off here and now it's off. I think the low glucose alert is probably the most valuable one, so we're going to keep that one on. Same thing, click high glucose alert, you can change that here. Signal loss, turn that on or off. Click done. And then once you're done changing to whatever you want it, you just say okay. Up here in the left-hand corner. Next thing you want to look at is sound and vibrations. That's simply how do you want to be alerted when something is off. So right now, you know, sound is on. You can also take it off and just use vibration, for example. So now it'll only vibrate when you have alerts. So I kind of like this setting. That's what I'm going to roll with. And just close down your device. After wearing the sensor for 2 weeks, you simply peel it off and you toss it in the trash. If it really sticks to the skin, or if you have a lot of body hair, you can consider using a glue remover like this one. I will link to that down in the video description. It'll just make it easier to take off the sensor. But let's take it off. There you go. And that just goes in the trash. Thank you so much for watching this video on how to get started with the Libre 2 system. I hope you found it helpful, and if you'd like to see more from me, please click the subscribe button and you'll be informed whenever I post new content. I always appreciate any interactions, so any likes or comments below are also appreciated. Thank you so much for watching.